We've seen some of baseball's best players come through St. Louis. Yogi Berra, Stan Musial, and Ozzie Smith, to name a few. There's another player on that list whose name you may recognize, but you might not be familiar with his role in baseball history.
Hall of Famer Bob Gibson.
In a town known as Baseball Heaven, Cardinal Nation's boisterous blessings are usually reserved for Redbirds.
The base burglar, Hall of Famer Lou Brock.
But this week, Cardinal fans praised an opponent.
We are honored to salute New York Yankees great Derek Jeter as he concludes a brilliant career this season.
St. Louis is a fitting stop on Jeter's farewell tour because a native St. Louisan paved the way for this pride of the Yankees.
And Elston Howard smashes a single to center, the sixth hit of the series for the steady Yankee catcher.
He was the second Jackie Robinson.
The year was 1955, and Vashon High School product Elston Howard had just become the first African-American to play for the New York Yankees, a moment in history Martin Matthews remembers well.
He was a pioneer for not only St. Louis, but I think throughout the world for young African-American, letting know if Elston Howard can do it, I can do it.
Elston Howard, the third Yankee All-Star catcher.
Howard's historic 1963 campaign featured one of his 9 All-Star appearances and his first of 2 Gold Gloves. At season's end, he became the first black player to win the American League's MVP award.
To be on that team and be the first African American, he had to be able to play and play real well. So yeah, we know he was a force and a factor.
Racism was also a force and factor.
The historic community of Princess Anne, Maryland became a racial battleground today.
Howard's wife Arlene shared something Jackie Robinson often told her husband.
He used to say to Elston, you know, I feel that your job is tougher than mine because the Dodgers wanted me, they came after me, they signed me, but the Yankees really didn't want Elston or I guess any African-American player at the time.
Controversy spurred camaraderie with Howard's Yankee teammates.
Yogi Berra, Whitey Ford, Mickey Mantle, all these players were wonderful to him and just embraced him.
Though his life changed in a New York minute, Howard saw St. Louis as a place where time stood still.
He was very much a family man, so that was very, very important to him to still ground his roots in St. Louis.
The home where Howard's roots were planted as a young boy once stood here in this empty lot overlooking the Compton Avenue Bridge. It's gone now like Elston. He died young at 50 of a heart condition, but his memory is very much alive just a few miles from here.
Elston Howard is our Jackie Robinson. This is a history lesson just like like Martin Luther King.
That history is on display at Howard's alma mater, Vashon High School. His Hall of Fame plaque sits feet from his portrait inside the field house that bears his name.
When I see that picture, I see greatness. I see hard work, I see talent, and I see an amazing man.
Feelings shared from the prep ranks to the pros.
It goes without saying, being the first African American in Yankee history, you know, what he's done, he's paved the way, helped pave the way for players like myself to come along.
You see, baseball fans love their legends. And we're lucky when another team's legend passes through town.
And what an ovation for Derek Jeter.
We are even luckier to have a legend like Elston Howard from our town. I'm Mike Colombo, News 4.